Okay, now in this lecture we're going to be talking about object-oriented programming. So object-oriented programming is actually a programming paradigm, simply saying it's a way of doing things, just as considering everything as an object. So the first two things that we have to consider is the object and the class. So a class is basically a structure of an object. It defines what an object should have, including properties and methods. So let's create a simple class and see how that works. Public class student, and this case can contain a property known as a string name. Next, another property int age. So the student has a name and an age. So if I go to public static void main to my main method, and then I create a new student, std equal to new student, and std.name is equal to my name. So as you can see, I have created a new object of this class. So the concept of object and the class can be identified in this method. So this is an object that is made according to this class. The next object-oriented programming concept is polymorphism. Polymorphism is having many forms. So as you can see, you have a class right here. It is known as foo, and it has a method known as bar, which does not return anything and does not have any kind of a parameter. So if I create another void typed function right here, void bar string args, and as you can see, there is no any kind of a compilation error right here. So if I console the right line, now I have some kind of a content in the first bar method, and then in the next method I'm gonna have something like this. Second method is called. Now if I go to foo.bar, as you can see, what method will be called? So you have one overloading. That means you have two methods with the same name and have different types or different polymorphized methods. So this is different from this. So if you call this, the first method is calling, and if you specify something else in this, the second method is calling. So why is that? Because this matches the second method right here, and it is actually a string, and this input is a string. So if I type 25, it is invalid because it is requesting a string from the arguments. So polymorphism is of two types. I forgot to say that the first thing is the operator overloading, and the second thing is the method overloading that I have done here. Method is overloaded by the same name with different kinds of parameters and kind of things. So that's polymorphism. The next object-oriented concept is inheritance. So what inheritance does? It gets the members from the base class into the derived class. So it is inheritance just like in the real world. So to explain this thing, I have done a simple example right here. It is a class known as animal, which has two methods, die and eat. So these are the two things that an animal can do. So the next class I'm going to specify is class human, which is going to inherit. So the inherit station symbol is the colon and from animal class. So as you can see, I have created a new class known as human. So let's create a new human. C equal to new human. C dot die. You can see the die and the eat methods are both right here because the members are derived to the derived type. This is the derived class and this is the base class. So as you can see, the animal has these two methods, and the human class also have both of those methods derived from the animal class. The next concept is abstraction. So to do this abstraction thing, first of all you need the abstract keyword in front of the declaration of the class. So I'm going to create a new method, public abstract void it, and it does not have any kind of implementation of it. So I'm gonna have a class duck, which inherits from animal, and this thing should do something like this. It should implement the abstract class, so it's like some kind of like interfaces that I have talked in some kind of other lesson. So you can, I have a link in the description down below, you can watch it right now. So it is gonna say console.writeLine the duck is eating. So abstraction is kind of a thing like this. If you create a new if you try to create a new object of animal, you cannot create it because an abstract class cannot be created, cannot be used as a type. So the thing you can use is duck d equal to new duck and d dot eat. And as you can see, the duck is eating will be going to be print on the console. So this is how abstraction works in C#. It just abstracts that there is a method, but you cannot call it in any time. So if you create an object, you cannot create object, by the way, in an animal class or something like this. But you can assign a duck to the animal, just like you do in an interfaces. So the last concept I'm gonna explain is encapsulation. Encapsulation is hiding objects or the hiding members of a class. So encapsulation is basically done by access modifiers like this, public, private, internal, and those kind of protected and those kind of access modifiers. So to implement this and show an example, I have created a simple class right here known as user, and I'm gonna create a simple member, a private member right here, private string address, and then I'm gonna create public string name, public int, no, private int age, and those kind of things. So I'm gonna create a new object for c equals new user. I'm gonna create a new user, and public can only access his name. So guess what, these members right here are encapsulated by using this private access modifier, because it is, it's private only to is, it's private, it can be only accessed by itself. So and in the constructor I'm gonna use c, this dot age itself can access all of those. So you can see a little bit of lock light right here in front of the box icon right here, and that means the object or the member is private. So that's encapsulation, and you have many other access modifiers which I'm gonna explain in a future video. So in this video tutorial, I have explained the 6 concepts of object-oriented programming: the object class, polymorphism, inheritance, and abstraction and encapsulation. So stay tuned for new tutorials from this channel, and thanks for watching. See you guys in the next video.